Now, one important principle of testing is to do extreme values. So in some sense, this is kind of an extreme value. We're testing one hand against itself. But there are other types of extreme values. What if the list of hands that's passed to poker has only one item, or zero items, or 100 items? Well, poker's not usually played as solitaire, so there wouldn't be much point in having one, but nothing in the specification rules it out. So add a test that checks when one hand plays that one hand is the winner. Now, what about zero hands? The specification doesn't say, but it does say that the function poker is supposed to return a hand, and if we pass it a list with nothing in it, then there's no hand to return. So I think the best thing to do is to make it clear that when we're passed zero hands, that's going to be an error. If you wanted to, you could return the value none. That might be a reasonable thing to return, but I think the best thing to do is just to say that that's an error. And we also want to have extreme values. What if 100 people are playing poker at once? If hands is a list of 100 different hands. We want to allow that too. It would be unusual, and we'd need a big deck of cards with 500 cards, but it could be done. So I want you to write tests to check for one player and to check for 100 players.